winners on the turn of a card on Card Shark. And if you play your cards right, you can win this beautiful new Cadillac Eldorado. And now, the host of Card Shark, Bill Rafferty.
Thank you. Thank you, everybody. Thank you. Thank you, Bob Hilton. Big Bob over there. Welcome, everybody, to Card Sharks. Of course, this is the show where you can win $32,000 on the turn of a single card. Don't forget our prize cards. We've got a champion who's won over $11,000 already. Let's get started right now. I always love to do this. Here come our dealers. Let's take a look at these ladies right now. Here come Lacey Pemberton and Susanna Williams.
Those
Carol Merrill hands that I'm working on over here.
Bill.
Let's deal out the cards, ladies. That means it's time to meet our card sharks. Here they come right now.
Yay!
Here's Maria.
Yay!
Maria is here. Maria is our returning champion. And I believe you're originally from South America?
Yes, from Colombia.
From Colombia, South America. How long have you been here?
I came by parachute.
You came by parachute. Oh, sit down, everybody.
So I came by parachute.
Now, how long have you been in the country?
Oh, about 16 years.
16 years now? When you were a young girl in South America, did you have game shows on television?
No, not like this.
Not like this,
No. This is exciting. This is wonderful.
Of course it's wonderful. This young lady has cash and prizes totaling $11,018.
Yay!
Very good. Very good.
Hello,
Doug.
How you doing, Bill?
Tell the folks at home a little about yourself, sir.
Well, I'm Doug Rittenhouse, and I am the director of a day camp program.
Yes, you are. You handle about 1,000 kids a day?
Daily.
Is that a field you get a degree in to do that, or did you just kind of stumble?
I sort of eased into it because I started out being a camper and just stuck with it all the way through.
Oh, okay. Well, good luck to both of you. I know you both have cut your cards backstage. Don't forget, we've added some prize cards to the deck. You can see some of the prize cards on Maria's side of the board right now. Maria has a diamond necklace, $500, a cruise. But those prizes can only be won when you win the match. And right now, a lot of heat is being put on Maria because she has she's not winning. Doug is ahead by one game, and that's the simple situation right now. She's got to win this game just to get a chance at this. So let's get started right now. It is now sudden death, ladies and gentlemen. Control of the board here, most important. And our first question is our audience poll question. And we have with us a lot of fun with these ladies all week. 10 woman bodybuilders. Here they are. Boy, there they are. They're all standing up there. Doug, this question is for you. Don't forget, it is sudden death. Our final question, control of the board here, the whole case. Before the show, we asked these 10 bodybuilders, do you ever stand in front of a mirror and flex your muscles? How many of these 10 bodybuilders do stand in front of a mirror and flex their muscles?
I mean, it's their career. They're going to do that. It's got to be all 10, no question.
All 10. Doesn't leave you a lot of room to work with, Maria.
Can I go higher? No.
If you go higher, I have to go out on Fairfax Avenue and get somebody.
That's a tough one. I mean, I cannot go higher.
No, it's not a bargaining tool, Maria. You got to go one way here.
Can I say 10 to?
No, I'm sorry. We can't have a tie.
I don't have a choice. Well, 9. Lower.
You got to go lower. Okay. She's out on a limb on this one, ladies and gentlemen. The actual number of these bodybuilders who stand in front of a mirror and flex their muscles is 10.
All right. All right.
I don't think that surprised anybody. Maria was stuck on that one. Well, because you hit this one right on the head, you get $100.
All right. Yeah.
Show me your stuff, girls. Let me see it. Oh, look at this. Oh. Look at this. That is amazing to me. That really is. All right. Now, Doug, we've got a situation. It's sudden death. You can change this card, play on, but if you make a mistake, you know that Maria automatically wins the game.
Mm-hmm.
Or you can force Maria to play off the 8. She makes a mistake. You win the game. What do you want to do? Play or pass?
Let's change it and play.
He's going to change and play.
Yep.
Interesting. The audience doesn't agree, but Doug is going to change this 9. If he makes a mistake, let's see what happens. He's got a 7 right now.
Okay.
Not a lot.
Higher.
Tough call. Right in the middle.
Higher
than a 7 for the game and the match. A diamond necklace.
Okay.
Interesting.
All right.
Interesting. Diamond necklaces goes on the side of the board, which makes this call even more important, because if he is right about this call, he's going to look good in a diamond necklace. You got a seven. What are we going to do?
Going to stay with it higher.
He's going to stay higher. Higher than a seven for the game and the match. It is. You did it. Terrific. Well, Maria, you were so nice. It was just wonderful to have you. I'm happy to tell you that instead of parting gifts, you have $11,018. And thank you so much for being a good champion. Bye-bye. Come here, Doug.
All right.
Bob Hilton, why don't you tell Doug what he won?
All right, Doug, you've won Kremer's Jewelry's stunning 18-karat yellow gold and platinum abstract pendant featuring four full-cut diamonds, a beautiful necklace furnished by Kremer. Back to you, Bill.
Thank you, Bob, for just pointing out the diamond necklace for Doug. When we come back, Doug's going to go on the money card, $32,000 available there. And do not forget the Eldorado. It's right back there. We'll be right back. My mic cable, you caught me. Welcome back, everybody. This is the fun part, as Doug said. I agree with him.
Yeah.
Here are Suzanne and Lacey. They're going to be dealing out the money cards. Now, let me tell you, in addition to all the money you can win on the money cards, we've added some jokers to the deck. If one of them turns up in the money cards, you will have the opportunity of winning this brand-new car.
It's the 1987 aerodynamically efficient Cadillac Eldorado with contemporary style. Features transverse front-wheel drive and state-of-the-art electronics furnished by Cadillac. And it's worth more than $27,000.
All right. Wow. You win that car, Doug, you can drive down there with your diamond necklace right in the front seat of that Eldorado. That'd be a lot of fun.
Yeah.
Now, for winning our match, we're going to get you started. We're going to guarantee you a chance at that car, because we're going to give you one joker, and Susanna's holding it right over there.
Great.
That's all there is to it. Let's get him started with $200, please.
Okay.
You play your cards right, Doug. You can turn $200 into $32,000. Let's take a look at your base card. A two.
Woo!
All of it.
Higher.
All of it. Higher than a two. He's got a seven. 400 on
change
a seven.
It with number three.
All right. Let's get a good card up here. That seven now becomes a joker.
All right.
That
all
is
right.
A good card. So he's got two chances at the car right now. Suzanne's going to hold on to that for you. Let's take a look right now. We're changing that
we're
seven.
We're going to change it, and we'll stick with number three.
Take number three. Ooh, let's take a look here. We've got a 10.
Okay.
All right. 400 on a 10.
200 lower.
200 lower than a 10?
Yeah.
He's got a jack.
Ooh, okay.
200 on a jack.
Okay. We'll go $100 higher.
I mean, 100?
Lower. Lower. Lower.
All right. All right. I'm glad you qualified that.
Right.
$100 lower than a jack, a 5.
Yeah. Okay.
$300.
Right.
We bring you up here. We'll give you $400 more. You have $700 on a 5.
500 higher.
500 higher than a 5. An 8.
Yeah. Okay.
1,200 on an 8.
Change it with number 2.
Changing it with number 2. Come on. A 5.
Okay.
A 5. 1,200 on a 5.
800 higher.
800 higher than a 5. A 3.
Oh.
400 on a 3.
Okay.
400 on a 3.
All of it higher.
All of it higher than a 3. An 8.
Yeah. Okay.
800 on an 8.
Right.
You've got $800 on an 8.
Right. Gonna all go lower.
You're gonna take it all.
All of
right.
It. Gotta
all
be.
Of it lower than an 8. It is.
Yeah.
There it is. $1,600 on the money card. Nice roll. Nice and tough call here.
Yeah.
You really did. Anyway, we're gonna be right back right after this commercial message. This gentleman's going to take his joker and try and win that Cadillac. We'll be right back. Welcome back, everybody. Here we are with Doug. Doug has $3,250 cash and prizes right in that pocket right there right now. But more important than that, here is Susanna with the jokers that he won during the money cards. You have two jokers, Doug.
Mm-hmm.
That means you have two opportunities to win that brand-new car. Behind one of those numbered cards up there is the word car. You find it with your joker, I will put you in the driver's seat. Go find
him. Okay.
Go find him for me. Two and seven. Two and seven. If the word car is behind here, Doug will never take it to the daycare center, I will guarantee it. It is! Wonderful, you got it! A brand new Eldorado. Is that nice? Is that wonderful? Ooh!
Oh,
what a campaign. Campaign. Wonderful.
That is
wonderful.
Thanks.
Well, you have just won for yourself $30,339 cash and prizes.
All right.
Okay. You know, of course, that that is it. We got to say goodbye to you.
Great.
But we're going to send you out the door with the Eldorado and the cash. Mr. Goodson is over there with the keys to the car and is now shakily signing a check. Go ahead over there and see
right.
him.
Thanks
Thank
a
you
lot.
So much, Doug. Bye-bye. We're going to be out right now with two more contestants. Let's meet them. Here they come. Hello, Joe.
Hi.
Good to see you, sir. Joe's playing from the champion position. These guys have flipped the coin backstage, so Joe got the champion spot. Joe, introduce yourself to the folks at home, please.
I'm Joe Prinicki. I live in Cheesequake Village, and that's in Albridge, New Jersey.
What's the name of that village?
Cheesequake.
Cheesequake?
Cheesequake Village.
Was it kind of like a soft earthquake? I don't understand Cheesequake. So you're from New Jersey?
I'm from New Jersey.
How nice. Good to have you here with us. Hello, Faye.
Hi. I'm Faye Killebrew from San Diego, and I'm the director of a children's dance school there.
You are?
Yes.
How nice. Well,
yes.
Good to have you here. I have a question for you. We have Viola up there, and you say Faye. Now, why
Uh-oh.
Is that? Why
Everybody
is that?
Knows now. My first legal name is Viola, and I go by my middle name, Faye.
Well, let me ask you a question. If you win money here, are you going to declare it on your taxes, Faye, or what?
I will declare it,
All right. We're checking now. Okay. So if I call you Viola or Faye, you'll answer.
I will.
Good enough. Both of you have cut your cards backstage?
Yes, sir.
Well, I just want to remind you about our prize cards. We have, in the new prize card section now, an Alaska cruise. That's $4,000. Color TV, 26-inch color TV, $5,000 cash card, a lot of goodies. Here we go. Here's our first question. It goes to Joe. This is an educated guess. Got to think about this, Joe. How old is Hugh Hefner?
Oh, brother. Well, he doesn't look very old, but he probably looks a lot older from the life he leads. But I would say 61.
You're going 61? What do you think, Faye?
Oh, gosh. He's been around a while, but I don't
You're going lower than
yes.
61?
Yes.
There's a very simple solution. You just count the rings around his pipe, and you'll find out. Hugh Hefner's age is 60, and is lower by one. Lower by one. So Faye slash Viola goes to the cards. We look at the base card. Tell me what you want to do. You got a 10.
Oh, I like to change that card.
Okay, the 10 now becomes a 4.
Yeah, okay, let's go higher.
Higher than a 4, we've got a queen.
Good, lower.
Lower than a queen, we've got an 8.
Hey.
Freezes on the 8. Freezes on the 8, protects her position, keeps Joe away from the cards. Next question, of course, goes to Faye. She gets it right, she changes the 8. We surveyed 100 married men and we asked them, when you're with your wife and you see a beautiful woman, do you pretend not to notice? How many married men said they do pretend not to notice a beautiful woman?
Well, not my husband. He notices them. They're beautiful. That's life. Okay. I'd say that's a pretty low number. How about 39% not to notice?
39? What do you think, Joe?
I don't know. I don't see anything wrong in pretending not to notice. Everybody says higher. I'll go higher.
You're going to go higher? You're going with the crowd?
I'll go with the run.
Also, you mean that plumber over there, honey? I really don't know. The actual number of married men who pretend not to notice a beautiful woman is 25. It is not higher, it is lower. It is lower. Faye, Viola, back to the cards. What about the 8?
I will change that, please.
I don't blame you. So the strategy pays off. That 8 now becomes an 8.
Let's go lower.
Lower than an 8. A 6.
Yeah, let's go higher.
Higher than a 6 to game number 1. It is. Tough call. Very tough call. That really was. Well, congratulations to Faye. Faye's got one game. First player to win two games, they win the match. And Susanna right now is already getting ready to deal out the cards for game number 2. Let's get started right now. And Joe, this is a must-win situation for you. If you don't win this game, you are going to see the land of parting gifts, Joe. You will be out of here. So, here's the first question, game number 2. We surveyed 100 psychiatrists and we asked them, generally speaking, do you think soap operas that show married women having affairs encourage women viewers to have affairs, too? How many psychiatrists said soap operas do encourage women to have affairs?
I believe that that's a good way to look at it. I imagine that if you watch that stuff, you sort of feel like, I'll say it's a nice high number. I'll say 71.
71.
Oh, please. Then, I see it on TV. Lower.
You're going lower.
Yeah.
Can't blame it on Alexis, huh?
No.
The actual number of psychiatrists who said soap operas encourage affairs is 49. It is lower.
Yeah,
so,
yeah.
With one game on her side of the board, back to it she goes. Tell me what you want to do. You got
I'll
a queen.
I'll keep that card and go lower.
Lower than a queen. We've got a trip to Alaska. That trip to Alaska comes up. That goes on Faye's side of the board. If she wins this game, she's going. Take a look at this card right now. We're going lower than a queen. It is.
Lower.
Lower than a jack, a four. Higher than a four and then a ten. Lower than a 10 for the game to match the trip to Alaska. It is. What a roll. Just terrific. Joe, I'm afraid you didn't spend a long time with us, but we loved having you here.
Thank
you so much, Joe. Good luck back in New Jersey. Come over here, Faye. Boy, that was good. Bob Hilton, why don't you tell Faye what she's got?
Absolutely, Bill. Well, we're going to fly you and a companion from Los Angeles to Vancouver, where you'll begin an exciting Alaskan cruise. You'll sail by magnificent glaciers and charming coastal towns while delighting in spectacular cuisine and nightlife. And this vacation package is worth more than $4,000.
Yeah. And when we come back, this young lady goes to the money cart. $32,000 available there. A brand new Eldorado. We'll be right back. Great. Welcome back. Little crew problem. We worked it out while you were away. Anyway, here are Susanna and Lacey. They're going to deal out the money cards for Faye. Faye is ready to do some damage. She knows how to play the money cards. Let me tell you quickly, we've added some jokers to the deck. Every time one of those jokers turns up, you will have the opportunity of winning this brand new Eldorado back there. So don't forget about that. And to guarantee you an opportunity to win that brand new Eldorado, we're going to get you started because you won the match with one joker. We've got one joker over there that Susanna's holding right now. And that's all there is to it. You ready to play the card?
I am ready.
Let's go and do some damage. Give her $200.
Here we go.
Tell me what you want to do, Faye. You've got an eight.
Well, change that card.
Which one do you want?
Oh, which one? How about number one?
That sounds good to me. Okay, that eight now becomes a five.
Good.
You have 200 on a five.
100 higher.
100 higher than a five. If it's another five, no win, no loss. It's a push. 100, higher than a 5, a 9.
Okay.
300.
$100 lower.
$100 lower than a 9. An 8.
Okay.
Watch that. You got $200. $200 on an 8.
All of it lower.
All of it lower than an 8 and 10.
Good.
$400 on a 10. You're doing some good work here now. Here's where we give you an additional $400. You have $800. You are playing off a 10.
Yes, I'd like to change that card.
Whatever
number
you want.
Number 2.
Card number 2. Let's take a look. Let's get some good cards up here. Yeah.
All right.
800 on a king.
$750 lower. Come
750
on.
Lower than a king is a king.
Oh, God.
No win, no loss.
That's
you're weighing off a king.
Lower. Come
seven,
on.
750 lower than a king.
Be there.
A 4.
Oh,
1550
God.
On a 4.
Oh, $800 higher. Come on.
800 higher than
Let's
a 4.
Go.
Hit it. $2,350. You have a queen. You must wager at least $1,175.
$2,000 lower.
$2,000.
Come on.
$2,000 lower than a queen. It is.
Thank you so much.
Wonderful. Yeah, you did it. You don't have to be thanking us. You did it. This young lady now has $8,587, and we will be right back right after this. Hey, Faye keeps telling me this is the ultimate. This is so exciting. I dreamed about this. Did you think you were good? Did you dream that you were going to win?
I dreamt I was going to win.
You did. You
yeah.
did. No? Well, you have won $8,587. So that's not a bad win at all. You've got some money in your pocket. Now, you've got some. You've got family at home you could spend it on, huh?
Yeah.
What do you
I
have
do.
Home?
Oh, gosh, I have my husband, Daryl, and my little 6-year-old girl, Summer. Hi, Summer.
Well,
and
we can't
Casey,
allow
14 months old.
Oh, we can't allow Summer and Casey's name to be mentioned. Please don't ever mention Summer and Casey's name on the air again, because we'll just have to do something about it. Anyway, we are going to have to pick it up tomorrow. Very exciting opportunity tomorrow because this young lady's going to play for the car. You forgot about it. Yeah. We will be back then. My name is Bill Rafferty. There's Lacey Pemmitt, Susanna Williams, Bob Hilton over on the microphone. We'll see you tomorrow on Card Show.
Some of our department.